Hello friends, welcome to Acknowledge India YouTube channel. This is Manoj. In the last session, we discussed about oceanic currents, and in this session, we are going to discuss about Atlantic oceanic currents. So let's see the northern part of the Atlantic Ocean, northern hemisphere. The South Equatorial Current bifurcates into two branches near the Cape de São Roque in Brazil. So from here, the South Equatorial Current bifurcate into two branches. Okay, these are two branches. So a part of this combined current enters into the Caribbean Sea and Gulf of Mexico. Okay, while the remaining current passes along the eastern side of the West Indies current. So here West Indies are situated. So they pass eastern side of the West Indies. Okay, the part of current which enters the Gulf of Mexico comes out from the Florida Strait and joins to the Antilles current. So this is the Florida Strait, so it joins to the Antilles current. So this combined currents move along the southeastern coast of USA as known as Florida current. So this current is called Florida current. Okay, beyond the Cape of Hatteras, it is known as Gulf Stream, and from here to this place is called Gulf Stream. Okay, so friends, a cold current from the Arctic Ocean is called Labrador current, which flows along the eastern coast of Canada, meets the warm Gulf Stream near the northeast corner of USA. Here, this is the place. Okay, the confluence of these two currents, one cold and the other warm, produce fog around this region. So here we have a heavy fog in this region. The Gulf Streams then deflated eastward under the combined influence of westerlies and the rotation of the earth, and then it crosses the Atlantic Ocean as the warm North Atlantic drift. Okay, so friends, in this journey, another cold current from Arctic called as the East Greenland current, which joins with the North Atlantic drift. The North Atlantic drift here bifurcates into two branches on the reaching of the eastern part of the ocean. Okay, the northern branch continues as a North Atlantic drift. Okay, this one is continued as a North Atlantic drift. It reaches British Isles, from where it flows along the coast of Norway as warm Norwegian current, this part. So friends, the Norwegian current is very useful for the movement of the ships in this ice covered area. The southern branch flows between Spain and Azores Island as a cold Canaries current. So this one, the Canaries current, finally joins the North Equatorial current, completes the circle. So friends, now we are discussing about southern part of Atlantic Ocean. The southeast trade winds maintain the South Equatorial current, which flows towards the west. Okay, where it divides into two branches, one branch that continues to the northern hemisphere and enters into the Caribbean region, and together with the small amount of water from the North Equatorial current as Guyana current, which entered into the South Brazilian current. Between the equatorial currents, the two equatorial counter currents flows towards the east and particularly well developed of Ghana. So friends, to the south of high pressure area of South Atlantic, the Brazilian current flows to the east and becomes the South Atlantic current. So this becomes the South Atlantic current, which turns towards the equator as the Benguela current when reaching the African coast. The Benguela current is more pronounced than its northern counterpart, the Canary current. Okay, and also it's characterized by lower temperatures near the coast. Okay, this coast have a lower temperatures. Further south, east flowing Antarctic circumpolar current which enters into the Atlantic Ocean through the Drake Passage. Sending one branch, the Falk Current. Here Falk Islands are there. This is traveling through the eastern side of the South American continent. Okay, the two major branch of Antarctic circumpolar currents continue to the eastward to the Indian Ocean, and sending the another branch to the northeastward and help the Benguela Current. So this gear, South Atlantic gear, this process will continue. Actually, this is the warm current and Benguela Current is the cold current. Okay.